Hello people, I'm Bharat Acharya. Welcome to our new video. So in today's video, we're going to learn branch instructions of 8051. We've been doing the whole instruction set of 8051. I've told you there are 111 instructions. One by one, we've been covering all of them. So you've seen data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logic instructions, Boolean instructions, that's bit operations. And now the very big group called branch instruction. It has 21 different instructions. What these instructions do? They cause a branch in the program. See, programs normally execute in a sequential manner. Why? Because of gravity? No. Because after every instruction, PC goes on getting incremented. What is PC? Program counter. It always gives the address of the next instruction. So the address, I am the processor, this is the memory. For me, any location in the memory can carry an instruction. I can fetch an instruction from anywhere. So the register PC, inside the processor there is a register called PC. Whatever address it gives, processor will fetch instruction from that address. Now as a principle, the moment any instruction is fetched, PC gets incremented. That is why program goes in a sequential manner. So that's the sequential flow, the default way a program works. But you've done programs in various languages, I'm sure you've done programs. You come across an if, you come across a go to, a for loop, a while loop, etc. A function call. These cause a branch in the program. So the instructions that cause a branch in the program are form the branch control group. That's what we are learning. The idea of causing a branch is to change the value of PC. Otherwise, PC goes on getting incremented. When you change the value of PC, you change the course of the program. Now, branches are of two main types. There's something called a jump and there's something called a call. The difference between the two, in a jump, you take a jump to a new location and you continue. You forget where you come from, you don't care where you come from. You just take a jump and you go ahead. Whereas, when you do a call, you're calling a function. A function is also called subroutines in assembly language. So you're calling a subroutine, so you call a function basically. You go to the function, execute it, but you don't stay there. You come back. See the difference. In a jump, you just go ahead and continue. In a call, you call a subroutine, execute it and come back. I'm going to teach you what are the various types of jumps. I have done a whole video. I'm sure you've seen the playlist. I've done a video on the difference between short jump, long jump and absolute jump. I'm not doing that again in this video. What's the point of teaching the same thing again and again? That is a theory topic, the three types of jumps, short, long and absolute. It's a fabulous topic. In Bombay University, it comes as a sure question of 10 marks. Okay, it's a very, very intricate topic. I've done a separate video for that. I'm not doing that right now. I'm teaching you the instructions. So there are three types of jumps, short, long, absolute. There are two types of calls and there are two types of returns. Why do you need a return? When you call a subroutine, you execute the subroutine. As I said, you don't just stay there. Then you come back. Now you won't come back by magic. There has to be an instruction for that. So the instruction is called return. It will surprisingly always get you back to the very next instruction. Of course, how does this work? I'm going to teach you in full detail. There is a role of stack in this operation. So I'm going to teach you that. Then we'll come to the conditional jumps, the one that I use much more often in programs. So there's something called CJNE. It has various types. There's something called DJNZ. The most important instruction of all of them in terms of usage, in terms of programming. Every loop in 8051 is made using DJNZ. This is like your for loop instruction. So I'm going to teach you that, the various types of DJNZ. Like we mentioned about looping, so I'm going to show you how to make loops. First we'll make an infinite loop, then we'll see various examples of finite loops. I've kept the space empty, I'm going to write all of that. And then there's a superb Viva question. How to generate 256 iterations using an 8-bit register. I don't know which question you'll get in Viva, but the subject is huge. It's anybody's guess what can be asked to you. But if you get this question and you are able to answer this, you have won your battle with the examiner. You impress the examiner. If somebody gives this answer to me when I'm taking a Viva, you really know, yeah, okay, this student knows the subject properly. Because this is not an answer that you find in textbooks. This is an answer which either you got to really think hard and get it, or you've done a lot of programs. That's when you realize it during programming. So anyways, I'm going to teach you how to get 256 iterations. Then there are more conditional jumps, jump if carry, jump if no carry, jump if zero, jump if no zero, indirect jump using A plus DPTR, and then bitwise jump instructions, JB, JNB and JBC. JNB is, if you've seen theory topic of 8051, if you've seen programs related to timers, related to serial ports, you know how important this instruction is. It's there in every serious program of 8051. It's the one that is used to check whether the timer has overflown or not, or whether your serial data has been completed, and so on. Anyway, whether your delay is over. So I'll be teaching you all of these instructions. Now, we're just about to start. Before that, you know what I've been doing all these days. We have our own website. It's called www.bharatacharyaeducation.com. The full version of this video will be there on their website. All you need to do is log into their website. You got to subscribe. Of course, this is professional service, but I've kept the fee ridiculously low. It's something that's not going to pinch anybody. You got to subscribe. Once you subscribe, immediately the videos are available. The whole channel of 8051 will be available to you. You can watch the videos unlimited number of times. And now, a big announcement. We are coming up with our own app. The app is ready. It's in the testing stage. The functionality is all done. It's an Android app that we're making first. The Apple app will also come very soon, but right now it's the Android app that's going to be released. The release date, as of now, what we've planned, if everything goes as per the schedule, is 20th March 2018, 2003-2018. So it's, if you see from now, it's about 2 weeks. The app will be there. Once you download, if you've already subscribed to the website, your subscription is automatically carried forward into the app. So you don't have to resubscribe or repay at all. And with the app, what you can do is you can download the videos, something that is not allowed in our website, but we are allowing in the app. You can download the videos. So what you can do is whatever video, suppose in the morning you decide these are the topics you want to learn today, just go and just download the videos where you get good internet connection, maybe a good Wi-Fi, high-speed Wi-Fi, or a cheap internet connection, whatever, however you want to play with it. Anyways, just download the videos. They're there in your phone now. Where you're traveling, when you're in an environment where the internet connection is not that strong, or whatever is the place you want to listen, you want to watch the video, you can watch it from your phone as many times. You can delete it again from the phone, re-download it if you want to, the way you want to work with it. Anyway, so the app is ready. It's just that, as I said, we have, since it's a commercial app, there's a lot of testing involved. So you're doing that testing. It should be launched by 20th March, hopefully before that. Okay, just wanted you to know that. Now let's start.